And let me take this across now to Kamaljeet Sandhu. She's joining us live from Delhi with the latest updates. Kamaljeet, you know, we were all discussing a rejig, a reshuffle. It turned out to be a complete overhaul, really, of the cabinet. And the focus seems to be on representation, on something that the Prime Minister has spoken about, Sabka Saath, if you really look at the composition now of the cabinet.
Absolutely. It was not just a jumbo cabinet reshuffle. This was a total overhaul, performance being a key. Names like Prakash Javadekar, Ravi Shankar Prasad, all being dropped at a significant point. This is obviously a course correction as far as the Modi government is concerned. They have new faces, some of them experienced. Now, remember, as far as ministers are concerned, now we know that as far as Mansukh Mandavia is concerned, he's got a key portfolio. Ashwini Vaishnav has got Meti. We've got Jyotiraditya Sindhya, who's got civil aviation. The education and skill development has gone to Dharmendra Pradhan. And again, when we talk about the likes of Anurag Thakur, who has information and broadcasting, Kiran Rijiju, who's all these ministers are way under 55. So young faces being given opportunity. The ones who perform much better have been given additional responsibility, have been elevated. So that is a key focus. Because remember, performance is something that they're keen on. The big takeaway is also the health ministry. Now, 2020 and 2021 have been COVID years. The performance as far as the health infrastructure, vaccination drive, response to COVID has been a major input as far as Modi government is concerned. And there have been a heavy criticism, both nationally as well as internationally. Now there is a new face in the so in that particular sense, the opportunity being given, but new team of Narendra Modi government is ready, and with these new faces, 2024 is something that the target is set on. Mm-hmm. But before that, there are key crucial assembly elections, including that one of Uttar Pradesh.
Yes.
And this is where things really stand as of now.
And you're right, that's been kept in mind as well. The representation from states that are going to polls next year. Kamaljeet, thank you for all those details. Let's now take a look at the big headlines from this cabinet overhaul and this reshuffle. What are the five big takeaways? Number one, 53 union ministries will now be handled by 30 ministers. That's the breakdown after yesterday's swearing-in ceremony. Also, what you'll notice is that the focus is on ensuring that there's maximum synergy within ministries. What that means is that ministries which have a common domain are clubbed. For example, you've got the IT ministry and railways that's been clubbed, and several other examples like that. Now, three MOS have been set up just for Home Affairs. So three of them have been appointed for Home Affairs alone. Very clear what the priority of the Modi government is. And finally, there was a new cooperation ministry that was set up. Amit Shah will be handling this particular ministry. And that tells you how much thrust the government is really giving on ensuring that there's adequate synergy, cooperation between all ministries, and the government works as smoothly as possible.